إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. فيا عباد الله، الله سبحانه وتعالى tests us in this world with different types of tests and trials. This world is a world full of this ibtila and imtihan, these tests and trials. And Allah has given us guidance in the Quran on how to deal with these tests and trials that come, how to deal with these difficulties that come. So from the guidance in the Quran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has informed us of is that nothing will happen to you except what Allah has decreed. Nothing can overcome a person except what Allah has decreed. فَمِنْ هِدَايَاتِ الْقُرْآنِ الْعَظِيمَةِ أن العبد لا يصيبه مصيبة إلا إن كان الله كتبها وقدرها. So from the great guidances of the Quran is that a servant should know nothing can overcome him except that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed upon a person to occur. ما شاء الله كان وما لم يشأ لم يكن. Whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills, then it will occur. And whatever He does not will, then it will not occur. So the servant remembers, everything is in the control of Allah. No matter what difficulty it may be, what calamity it may be, what trial or test it may be, then the servant knows and remembers that nothing happens and occurs or afflicts you except that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed. It is mentioned in the Quran, قُلْ لَنْ يُصِيبَنَا إِلَّا مَا كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَنَا. Say that nothing will overcome us, will afflict us, except that which Allah has decreed and written upon us. هُوَ مَوْلَانَا وَعَلَى اللَّهِ فَلْيَتَوَكَّلِ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. He is our protector, and put your trust in your Lord. Put your trust in your Lord for those who are the believers. They put their trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, knowing that everything is in the control of Allah. Secondly, from the guidance the Quran has given us, is that when some difficulty happens, some trial or tribulation happens, then nobody can remove that except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nobody can remove that calamity, can remove that difficulty except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So as it is mentioned, it is Allah, the one who removes the harm, and Allah, the one who brings the good. No good can come to you except what Allah decrees for you, and no harm can be removed from you except what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decrees for you. Hence it is mentioned in the Quran, أَمَّنْ يُجِيبُ الْمُضْطَرَّ إِذَا دَعَاهُ وَيَكْشِفُ السُّوءُ. Who is the one that answers the dua of the one in distress and removes that evil, removes that harm and difficulty and evil from the person? Then of course it is Allah alone. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone removes that difficulty from a person or brings that goodness to a person. Similarly, from the guidance that the Quran has given us in regards to these affairs is to make sure that a believer maintains his trust in Allah at all times, no matter how difficult the situation may be, no matter how much the calamity may be, whether it is in your wealth, whether it is in your health, whether it is in your family and children, whatever the calamity or difficulty may be, the believer maintains his trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why Allah mentioned in the Quran, أَلَيْسَ اللَّهُ بِكَافٍ عَبْدَهُ. Is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not sufficient for his servant? Then certainly Allah suffices us. Certainly Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala controls all of our affairs. Similarly, Allah mentioned in the Quran, وَمَنْ يَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ فَهُوَ حَسْبُهُ. That whomsoever puts his trust in Allah, then Allah will suffice him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will suffice the person, the believer, who puts his trust and dependence in Allah. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned in a hadith, إِذَا خَرَجَ الرَّجُلُ مِنْ بَيْتِهِ فَقَالْ. That when a person leaves his home and he mentions, بِسْمِ اللَّهِ تَوَكَّلْتُ عَلَى اللَّهِ وَلَا حَوْلَ وَلَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ يُقَالُ حِينَئِذٍ هُدِيتَ وَكُفِيتَ وَوُقِيتَ. That when a person leaves his home and he says, in the name of Allah, I put my trust in Allah, and there is no might, no power except by Allah, then it is said to him that you have been guided and you have been sufficed and you have been protected. These are from the guidances of the Quran upon us. Another guidance that the Quran directs us to in times of difficulty and trials and tribulations is that a believer continuously makes dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the difficulty to be removed, for the hardship to be eased. Constantly makes dua, asking Allah to bring that matter of ease for him. And that is why Allah mentioned in the Quran, وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمُ ادْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. Your Lord said, call upon me and I will answer you. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ عَنْ عِبَادَتِي سَيَدْخُلُونَ جَهَنَّمَ دَاخِرِينَ. Those who are arrogant in making dua to me, then they will enter the hellfire. Allah tells us to make dua and to return back to him with our affairs. Similarly, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِي إِذَا دَعَانٌ. That when my servant asks you about me, then indeed I am close, and I answer the dua of the one who calls upon me. So this is also from the guidance the Qur'an has given us to maintain our dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in all times of difficulty and hardship. And certainly these days we find and experience some degree of difficulty in the affairs that are occurring with coronavirus and COVID. We find some difficulties in our lives. We find some restrictions in our lives. We find some hardships occurring these days. So what does the Quran tell you to do? To maintain your trust in Allah, to continue with dua, asking Allah to make the affair easy, to remove this hardship and difficulty from us, just as the scholars, the senior scholars of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah have all advised likewise from this guidance of the Quran. And similarly, from what we find in the guidance of the Quran, is what we began by mentioning at the start. The Quran tells us that this life is a life that is a test. The Quran tells us this life is a life where tests and trials, they will certainly occur. الَّذِي خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةَ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ. Allah who created the death and life to test you. أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. Who from amongst you will be the best in actions? And similarly, there are other ayat in the Quran which indicate this same type of meaning. And in a hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, عَجَبًا لِأَمْرِ الْمُؤْمِنِ. How amazing is the affair of a believer. إِنَّ أَمْرَهُ كُلَّهُ خَيْرٌ. All of his affair and his circumstances are good. وَلَيْسَ ذَاكَ لِأَحَدٍ إِلَّا لِلْمُؤْمِنِ. And that is not something which can happen for anyone except a believer. إِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ سَرَّاءٌ شَكَرَ فَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُ. If something good happens to him, he thanks Allah, shows his gratitude, and that's good for him then. وَإِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ ضَرَّاءٌ صَبَرَ فَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُ. And if some difficulty overcomes him, some hardship or calamity, then he shows patience at that time, and that is then good for him also. So all of the circumstances of the believer are good for him, no matter if it is goodness or if it is difficulty. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. فيا عباد الله, we have seen briefly some of the types of guidance the Quran gives us, in particular in times of difficulty or hardship or some type of calamity that may overcome the people. The Quran gives us guidance as to how we behave as believers, that we know that everything which occurs is by the decree of Allah, and nothing will happen to us, no hardship or calamity or trial will overcome us except by the decree of Allah. Even if it be this disease, a person is not afraid of that. You put your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you know that it is all by the decree of Allah, and nothing will happen to you except by the decree of Allah. You maintain your trust, you maintain dua in asking Allah for good health, in asking Allah to cure those who are ill, in asking Allah to remove the difficulty and hardship. You maintain that trust in Allah, knowing that the believers have been commanded in the Quran to have their trust and dependence in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the manner that the believer behaves in. This is the manner that the believer maintains his trust in Allah and dua regularly and constantly, knows that it is all in the control of Allah what happens in this world, and knows that it is all a test. Everything is a test. This short life that we all live, a life that will be filled with different types of situations for every person. Times of goodness and happiness, and times of difficulty and distress, times of calamity and affliction, they will occur. Everybody knows, Allah has told us in the Quran, this life is a life that is a test and a trial. So we are here to see who will be from the patient and righteous servants of Allah, maintaining their trust in Allah, their dua, asking Allah when these tests and trials they occur, and who will be from those who abandon their trust in Allah and they lose hope in Allah, and they are the ones who have not understood the guidance of the Quran. So be aware, tests and trials will always happen in this world. One comes and it goes, then another one will come, and then it goes, and another different one comes and it goes. But the believer remembers his purpose in this world, his purpose to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to maintain his ibadah and his ta'ah to Allah, no matter what the difficulties and the situations may be. And the companions and the prophets, they faced even bigger difficulties than what we face today. And yet they continued upon their worship and obedience, their trust in Allah and their dua. They continued and maintained all of that. So that is what is upon us also, to continue and to maintain that path, the path which the Quran has guided us to. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from those firm believers with our trust in Allah, to be from those who constantly return back to Allah in dua, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to improve our affairs and to bring goodness for us and to remove the harm from us. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad. Aqim as-salah.